Hello everyone, welcome again to my channel. Today I will do the unboxing of the Humidigi A7S. Let's start with some specs. It comes with the MediaTek 6737 quad-core processor. It has Android 10 Go. It comes with 2 GB of RAM. 32 GB of ROM. It has a 4150 mAh battery, 6.53-inch HD plus screen, back camera 30 MP, 8 MP, 2 MP, front camera 8 MP. And as you can see, it supports almost all bands, so I think you can use this one worldwide. Okay, let's see what's inside the box. First of all, we have the phone. We have the envelope. With a short manual. SIM card ejector tool. The charger. I don't know if I can get it clear, but it's a 5-volt, 1 ampere charger, standard charge. And it has a USB-C charging cable. Okay, let's see the phone. Phone comes with a standard silicone case. Not the black one now, but it's a clear case, which is also nice instead of the black one. Okay, the phone itself feels good, especially for this price. It looks also very strong. It doesn't look cheap at all. Now, let me take this out. Okay, as you can see here, this should be the 8 MP camera. This one the 30 MP. This one I think is wide angle. And macro. And it comes with an infrared thermometer. Okay. The back cover really looks nice. It's with texture. It's certainly is anti-fingerprint, which is also very good, of course. It feels strong. Phone is not heavy, it's normal. Okay, on top we have the headphone jack. Left side we have the SIM card slot. And here we have a side key, maybe you can choose for what you want to use it. We will see later in my review. On the right side, we have the volume button, power button. And as you can see, it's USB-C. I don't know if we can get it a little bit more clear. Microphone, speakers. Okay. I will set up my account and then I will come back to you. I finished set up my account. With this phone there is no fingerprint scanner, so you have to use your PIN, or you can also do face unlock. We'll try to set up face unlock. This is pretty slowly. Okay, enroll face. Here's my PIN. Start enroll. Okay. Face registered. You can also choose where you want to use it for. Let's try. It's working, but it's slowly. Okay, I will do a close up. No, that's the same. There's no difference between close up or a little bit away from your face. Anyway, it's working, but it's slowly. Okay, about the software on the phone, I didn't find any bloatware. This is all that was on the phone. These are three apps for myself. We have the tools. In tools, you can find the thermometer and Zello. That's an app you can use your phone as like a walkie-talkie. Thermometer, you can temperature people or objects. For people, you have to keep it in front of their face, 1 to 3 centimeter. I will check. I don't think that's really my temperature, but that's what it says. You can see on my... Let's try objects. I'll try my watch. No. 25.4 Celsius. Okay. I don't know if it's just a funny tool or if it is, if you can really use it. Okay, now anyway, I don't know if people will use it on this phone. You can calibrate it. It is an option. You can activate it also, not only via the software, but also the side button. As you can see, the side button you can also change if you want. There's also an option for in the settings. Let's see where it is. Oh, here, smart key. As you can see, you can program the smart key. One click is, on this moment, it's thermometer, double click is Zello, long press is the flashlight. And you can choose a lot of different applications for that. Okay. Let's see in the settings. Settings is pretty standard because it's stock. Android 10, but then the Go version. We have the network settings, connected devices, apps and notifications, the smart key, Smart Assistant, you can choose your navigation, how you want to navigate through the menus. Battery, display, sound, storage, privacy. As you can see, standard, which is nice. I always like the stock ROM. Now we go to the phone. Android 10. Comes with the security patch from September 5. Google Play system update is August 1. I'll show you some extra specs. The model A7S, Humidigi. Hardware, it's the MediaTek 6737, European version. This is strange. Installed RAM 1.5 GB, total RAM 2 GB. That's very strange. I saw already on YouTube from different people that here it says 2 GB installed RAM. Why mine is only 1.5? Maybe it has something to do with the European version, I don't know. Anyway, available memory 688. Internal storage 25 GB. Free storage at the moment 23 after I installed my apps. It's not much, but it's okay, especially for a phone like this. Let's go to the CPU. Here it says it's the MediaTek 6735. It's a quad-core processor, runs at 1300 MHz. It's running in 32-bit mode. The display, screen resolution of 720x1600, 6.52 inches, 269 dpi, comes with the Mali T720 on 60 Hz. Okay, let's do some gaming again. It's running smooth, but I have a feeling that there is some lags. It seems that my controls are not so quickly responding. But it's running okay. It's playable. I don't think you can play high resolution games if this game is already a little bit slowly. As you can see, the game was running okay, but I had a feeling that the response was not really fast enough as it should be. But it was playable. Not bad actually for this phone. Let's go to the photos, the photo camera. Let's see the camera. Now, it also looks pretty standard. We have a picture mode and a portrait mode. I don't know if you can see it, but there is also, you can also choose wide angle. And here you can 2 times zoom. Ja, oké. Go to settings. Scene mode, self timer, shutter sound, watermark. Picture size maximum is 13 megapixels. Rear camera. Video mode. You also have wide angle, so you can take videos in wide angle mode, which is quite nice. Video quality maximum is HD. We have the selfie camera. Video quality also is maximum HD. You go to picture. Picture quality. Maximum 8 megapixel. Okay, I would say let's go outside to make some pictures and videos. Well, I took some pictures and videos, and the rear camera really disappoints me. I don't know if it is my device or that the camera is just useless, because I see other reviews of this phone and the pictures are not that good quality, but mine, they are even bad. Very unclear. It seems that the camera is constantly focusing, and when I press the button on the right time, pictures or video are okay. But when you think you put it sharp, you make a photo, it's nothing. I will show you the pictures, but I think it's my device. I will see if I can try to connect Humidigi about it, or if I just wait for an update. I hope, because I like the phone. It's not really that fast, but it's okay. But the camera really disappoints me. And the front camera is okay, as you can see in the pictures. Front camera is working fine. Anyway, I will show the pictures first, and you can see what I mean. Nice phone. I wouldn't say that it's a phone for daily use if you play a lot of games, but for normal games, for simple games and daily use like texting or calling, social media, this phone is perfect. I will continue testing and I will come back to you about this phone. It's also running smooth. And then for this price, like about 60 euro on Banggood, it's a good price actually. I would recommend this phone. Okay, now I will continue testing this phone and I will make another review of it. And I hope to find out more about the camera. So if you like this review, please like and subscribe. If you have any questions about it, ask me and I'll try to answer it. And I will see you again next time in another video. Bye bye.